This is Kampala Bible Revelation Church, located at Makerere Mukubira Zone along Paulo Chinji Road. We are celebrating 25 years since this ministry began. On Sunday, 8th January 1995, Kampala Bible Revelation Church was born with about 25 people at Makerere University Faculty of Arts Lower Lecture Theatre. The covenant scripture for this ministry is from Ezekiel chapter 37, verses 26 to 28. Through this covenant, thousands of lives have been blessed, multiplied, and impacted in Uganda and around the world. The church has grown and has several branches, namely KBRC City Branch, Wachiso, Chengera, Chetume, Kabuja, Bweyogerere, Chankwanzi, Nakauka, and still growing. Testimonies abound from the young to the old, and yet it is only the beginning. We also have Doers of the Word Bible Institute. This is the teaching arm of our ministry, mandated with the commission of teaching believers the practical principles of God's Word. Throughout the 25 years, thousands of church leaders and believers have been and continue to be transformed through this Bible Institute. Please join us as we celebrate God's placement at 25.
Praise the name of the Lord. God bless you for tuning in to Kampala Bible Revelation Church, the online church. Today is our midweek service, and I want to welcome you so much in the presence of the Lord. Let's give thanks. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for giving us this opportune time to be in your presence. Thank you, Lord, because you are in our midst. We have gathered in your name, and you are in our midst. We thank you for your presence in our lives. In Jesus' name, amen. Hallelujah. Wherever you are, please get ready as we open today's service. Let us read Proverbs chapter 15, verses 30. His word is all we need. Proverbs chapter 15, verses 30. Scripture says that the light of the eyes rejoices the heart, and a good report makes the bones fat. Welcome God's word that will become a rejoicing of your heart. Father, in Jesus' name, I welcome your word, which is the light to my feet, which is the lamp unto my feet and the light to my path. I welcome your word. It's going to become the rejoicing of my heart. It's going to become joy in my heart. Father, thank you for your word in Jesus' name. If you have prayed, put your hands together for the Lord. He's going to give us his word. Thank you, Jesus. This is our month of marvelous light of joy. Your light is turning into joy. As we welcome the Holy Spirit, Romans 14, 17. The kingdom of God is not meat and drink, but righteousness and peace and joy in the Holy Ghost. The Holy Spirit is the custodian of joy. In our month of joy, we're going to invite the Holy Spirit to turn God's word into joy. Come on, raise your voice right now. Father, in the name of Jesus, we welcome your Holy Spirit. Fill us with your Holy Spirit. In this service, we welcome the Holy Spirit to turn God's word into joy. He is the custodian of joy. Let the word of God turn into joy. Father, we thank you in Jesus' precious name. Hallelujah. I am so glad you're in the service right now. I want you to get ready right now because we're going to praise the Lord. Focus on the Lord only. Come in his courts with singing, with rejoicing, with dancing. God bless you. Thank you.
to the name of Jesus. Hallelujah to the name of Jesus. We lift up our hands to bless the name of Jesus. In our hearts to praise the name of Jesus. There is no name like the name of Jesus. It is a powerful name. It is a name that is above all the other names. I'll praise your name, Jesus, forever. You have dropped the charges by this name. Thank you, Jesus.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord again and again. We worship His holy name. What a wonderful day we have gathered in His presence. Oh, praise the Lord. You can worship Him. You can praise Him again. Thank Him for the praise service. Thank God for the songs we've just heard. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for the songs we have just used to praise your name and to worship you and to glorify you. Just praise the Lord right now. Praise the Lord. We thank you, Lord Jesus, for this time. It's a wonderful, wonderful time. Everyone praise the Lord and praise the Lord again and again. Amen and amen. Praise the Lord. You're welcome. We have gathered together in the name of the Lord Jesus, and He's in our midst. Jesus is in our midst. We have gathered in His name. And we know that great things are going to happen. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord again and again. There's nothing as exciting as knowing that the Lord is on our side. There's nothing as exciting as knowing that the Lord is on our side and that we are victorious in every way. Oh, praise His holy name. Bless the name of Jesus. Once again, I want to remind you, welcome to Kampala Bible Revelation Church, everyone. This is our midweek service. And I just want to remind you to send someone a link. Send someone a link. And share with them. Someone maybe you've never shared with before, but you feel you are led by the Lord to send that link. Send that link. And the Lord will bless you. And the Lord will bless that person as well. I just want to remind you that we have migrated from 5 p.m. to 7 p.m. Because now we can be home by this time. Because by 5, some people are just rushing from town and other things. But right now, we thank God that everyone is likely to be home. Praise the Lord. I just want also to remind you that our praise week is coming. Our praise week will be beginning the other Sunday, 26th July. And all the way up to 30th. From Sunday to Thursday, we are going to be praising the Lord every day for a full hour from 7 to 8, praise His holy name. So I just want you to get sense. We are going to be in His presence and worship Him and praise Him. I'll be giving you more details as well as we go on. Praise the Lord. So now it's time to go to the Word of God. And I just want you to get set. Let's pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you. We bless your name. We worship you because this is the day that you have made. We glorify your name because we are right in your presence. We thank you because we are two or three are gathered together. In your name, there you are in their midst. We know you are here to do miracles. We know you're going to heal. We know you're going to deliver. And we know that you're going to send your healing word. You're going to send your delivering word. You're going to send your power-packed word. You're going to send your miracle-working word, joy-giving word, wisdom-giving word. We receive it right now, and we thank you, and we magnify your name in Jesus' precious name. And everyone said a good amen. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. So, the Lord has given us His word today. Marvelous light of transformation. Marvelous light of transformation. Don't forget, this is my year of His
marvelous light, that you may show forth the praises of him who has called you out of darkness into his marvelous light. That's 1 Peter chapter 2 and verse 9. Very important. And this month is our month, his marvelous light of joy. And the joy of the Lord is your strength. Praise his holy name. But today, every Thursday, we share together the marvelous light of the Lord. The word of the Lord comes to us by revelation and great things happen into our lives. So today it is marvelous light of transformation. In other words, understanding that this year the Lord is sending to you his marvelous light because he wants you to be transformed. Praise his holy name. That he's sending his marvelous light this whole year to you because he wants you to be transformed. And that is so, so, so important. Let me share with you the first scripture. It is in Romans chapter 12. Romans chapter 12. Romans chapter 12 and verse 2. Praise his holy name. Romans chapter 12 and verse 2. Romans chapter 12 and verse 2 says, "And be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind, that you may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God." This verse is loaded. Praise his own name. But he's talking about being transformed because we cannot conform to this world. We cannot go the way the world goes. We cannot do things the way the world does them. We cannot begin to be like them. Now, that must open your eyes. There's something in the world that God does not want us to mingle with or to tamper with. So he says, be not conformed to this world. How is that possible? But be transformed by the renewing of your mind. In other words, something must happen to my mind which will cause a transformation, which will lead me not to be conformed, which will lead me to reject the conformation to this world, which will lead me to prove the good and acceptable and perfect will of God. That must be important. That's very, very, very important. That we are not conformed to this world, that's very important. Now, I want you to know that in 1 John chapter 5, verse 19, 1 John chapter 5 and verse 19, very common verse, he said, we know we are of God. 1 John 5:19. He said, we know that we are of God. And the whole world lies in wickedness. We know that we are of God. And we also know that the whole world. Now, when he says whole world, he means whole world. The whole world. Now, some people may get mixed up with this. Now, when the Bible talks about it, the worlds that God created with his word. In Hebrews 11, verse 3, he said, by faith we understand the Lord created the worlds by his word. Those, he's talking about the planets, the earth, and the systems. But when he talks about the world, which is in wickedness, he's talking about the devil's system, the devil's world. He's the god of this world. The devil is the god of this, Satan is the god of this world. And he has said, as for us, we know we are of God, and the whole world lies in wickedness. So when you begin to be conformed to this world, you are conforming to wickedness. That's what he said in Romans chapter 2. Be not conformed to this world, but be transformed by renewing your mind, that you may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God. Very important. This year, the Lord is releasing his marvelous light to you that you may be transformed. That you may be transformed so you may not conform to this world. So you may not conform to the ways of this world. The world, they lie to get wealth. They kill to get wealth. The whole world lies in wickedness. There is no one, there is no single one that is righteous in this entire world. All of them are in wickedness and they are wicked. But thank God we are born of God. We are of God. We are born of God. Oh, bless the name. Bless the name of Jesus. So, go with me to Luke chapter 16. Luke 16. I want to show you something here, so you may appreciate the marvelous light that comes to you every day. Luke 16 and verse 8. Jesus said, "And the Lord commended the unjust steward, because he had done wisely. For the children of this world," which is wicked, "for the children of this world are in their generation wiser than the children of light." We are both the children of this world and the children of God, or children of light. We are both in this world. But Jesus said, these are the words of Jesus. He said, those guys are wiser. They are wicked, yes, but they are wiser. This means, therefore, that God wants you to be wiser than the wisest of this world. That's why he wants you to be transformed daily by renewing of your mind. To be transformed so you may not conform to the system of that. Now, if you try to conform to this world, those children of the world are wiser. There's no way you can beat them. There is no way you can catch them. There's no way you can beat them. You cannot compete with them. So you need to be transformed by the renewing of your mind. Every day, marvelous light is coming to you that you may renew your mind. Every day, marvelous light is coming to you that you may renew your mind. Isn't that wholesome? That's glorious. Bless his holy name. So Jesus himself said that children of this world, if the children of light are to compete, the children of this world are wiser. So you cannot compete with them. Oh, pastor, they are rich, but I'll beat them. I'll be richer. You cannot. Those guys are wiser. They can even, they're not only wise, they are even crude. They can kill, they can deceive, they can steal. You can't do that. You can't conform to this world. You are a child of God. That's why you need to renew your mind every day. You know what? You renew your mind so you may be transformed. You renew your mind. You receive new information. You receive new updates. So you may be able to prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God. You see, the will of God does not change. The will of God does not change. But the situations change. And because the situations change, because of the wickedness, that's why you need new updates. You need new updates. You need new passwords. I think I can use that one. Every day you need a new password. For that day, from the King of Kings, from heaven, you need this. So every time marvelous light is coming to you, you welcome it, because this marvelous light is coming with a new password for that day. It's coming with new information. Now, a very good example. At one time, God told Moses to strike the rock. And Moses went and struck the rock, and water gushed out, and people drank. The second time, he had changed the password. He said, go and speak to the rock. He would have said, go and strike the rock again. But he didn't say, he changed the password. And Moses went with his old password. He went with his old password. He hit the rock. Water gushed out, but his ministry ended there. Water gushed out, but his ministry ended there. So every time marvelous light is coming to you, every day you're getting new password. New password, because the situations have changed. God does not change. His will does not change. Situations change. The enemy is ever, the Bible calls it the wiles of the devil, the evil schemes. He's ever scheming. So you cannot go with yesterday's password. If you go with yesterday's password, you'll get into trouble. Another word for another beautiful example for, well, I can say transformation is a process. This is what the user dictionary say, that transformation is a process of profound and radical change that orients someone in a new direction and takes him or her to an entirely different level of effectiveness. Isn't that awesome? That's what transformation is all about. You are profoundly and radically changed in the way you think, and you even change direction. You get into a new direction, which will take you to a different, completely different level, different area of operation, where you will be most effective. So we need to be transformed every day. We need to be transformed every day. We need to be how do we get transformed? By the renewing of our minds. Let me tell you something. The anointing cannot transform you. The anointing of God cannot transform you. It takes the renewing of your mind for you to be transformed. You know why? Because the anointing is a tool. The anointing is a tool. Don't tell me that a hammer transforms a carpenter. Can a hammer transform a carpenter? So it's the anointing of God. So you need the marvelous light of God. You need his word every time to come to you to renew your mind so you may be transformed. Let me give you another good example of transformation. You know, all of us know what caterpillars are. You know, in our early primary science, we call it metamorphosis. But actually, that's transformation. A caterpillar transforms into a butterfly. That's what transformation is all about. A caterpillar is walking around. It has no wings. A butterfly has wings. A butterfly sucks nectar from the flowers. You know, a caterpillar is just eats everything. It just crushes everything. It's moving all over the place. If you touch it, its hair, it has hair stings, and you know, and it will burn your skin. There is a big difference between a caterpillar and a butterfly, and yet that is the same insect. It's the same insect, but there's a big, big difference between a caterpillar and a butterfly. What type of Christian would you want to be? Do you want to be a caterpillar or a butterfly? Praise his holy name. You are to be a butterfly. That's why you need his marvelous light every day to be transformed. You need his marvelous light every day. So you renew your mind. You get his word every day to renew your mind, to get new password for the day. If you don't receive his marvelous light, his word, if you don't receive his marvelous light, which is his word, you are missing out on your new password for the day. Oh, bless his holy name. Let me show you another scripture. Go with me to 1 John chapter 5. 1 John chapter 5 and verse 4. 1 John chapter 5 and verse 4. It's awesome. 1 John chapter 5 and verse 4. Very common verse. It says, whatever is born of God, whatsoever is born of God, overcometh the world. Whatever is born of God. Isn't that good news? Whatever is born of God overcomes the world. Then it says, and this is the victory that overcomes the world, even our faith. Even our faith. So if any born again is to remain in this victory, you must build your faith. You must grow your faith. So every day I receive his marvelous light to grow my faith. Actually, I'm renewing my mind as I'm growing my faith and I'm getting transformed. What I believed yesterday is not what I'm believing today. I have been transformed. Yesterday, I was believing for 1,000. Right now, I'm believing for 1,000,000. I've been transformed. Yesterday, I believed for healing. Now, I'm believing for divine health. I've been transformed. We are constantly transformed if we renew our mind daily by growing our faith as we receive his marvelous light. Oh, bless his holy name. This is very, very exciting. And as a child of God, you have to know that the Lord is sending his marvelous light to you that you may overcome the world on a daily basis. Whatsoever is born of God overcomes the world. Every day, the world must be under your feet. Why? Because it lies in wickedness. You can't conform to its ways. You can't conform to this world. Because it's under the wicked one. Oh, bless the name of Jesus. In John chapter 17, you know what? I made up my mind, I cannot conform to this world. John 17 and verse 15. Look at this. Verse 15. Jesus was praying and said, I pray not that thou should take them out of the world, but that thou should keep them from the evil. They are not of the world, even as I am not of the world. That's why we cannot conform to this world. We are not of this world. We must not prosper the way they prosper. We must not handle issues the way they handle issues. We must not handle our enemies the way they do handle their enemies. We must not. Everything around us is different, and yet we are in this world. But we are not of this world. So he has said, Jesus said, I'm not praying that you take them out of here, wicked as it is. Wicked as Jesus prayed, wicked as this world is. He prayed and he said, I do not pray that you take them out of this world, but that you keep them from the evil one. Though we are in a wicked world, but we are kept from the evil one. Jesus prayed. Then he said, why should they be kept from the evil one? Because they are not of the world. The world has no power over you. The world and everything in the world. It has sickness, it has diseases, it has failure, misfortunes, and curses, and death. All those things have nothing to do with you. They have no power over you. The entire world has no power over you. That's why every day you need to receive the renewing of your mind. You need to remind yourself every day, the world is under my feet. The world is under my feet. Sickness has no power over me. You need to renew your mind every day, to remind yourself every day. And by doing so, you'll get transformed. By doing so, you cannot conform to the ways of this world. Jesus himself, by the way, in verse 9 of the same chapter, Jesus said, I pray for them. I pray not for the world. The Lord Jesus has never and cannot pray for the world. That is stinging. That is stinging. Yeah, that's very stinging. Jesus never prayed for the world. He said, I pray. John 17 verse 9. He said, I pray for them. I pray not for the world. And the world is wicked. The world is wicked. And it will be coming more. It is getting more and more wicked. Oh, bless the name of Jesus. But whoever is born of God has overcome the world. Why? Because every day we are renewing our minds and we are getting transformed. So we may not conform to this world. Oh, bless the name of Jesus. In 1 John chapter 2, 1 John chapter 2 and verse 15. 1 John chapter 2 and verse 15. Praise the Lord. 1 John chapter 2 and verse 15. He said, love not the world, neither the things that are in the world. Can you imagine that? Do not love the world, neither the things in the world. If any man love the world, the love of the Father is not in him. For all that is, verse 16, for all that is in the world, the lust of the flesh and the lust of the eyes and the pride of life is not of the Father, but is of the world. So I have every reason to renew my mind every day. I don't just study the Word of God because I'm born again, and you know, because I'm born again, so I have to read the Bible. No, I'm renewing my mind. I'm getting marvelous light. Marvelous light is shining in dark places of my life. I'm renewing my mind. And as I renew my mind, I'm getting transformed from a caterpillar to a butterfly. I'm getting transformed from a caterpillar to a butterfly. Oh, bless the name of Jesus. And as I renew my mind, I begin to see things as I've never seen them before. I begin to see healing as my portion. I begin to see things that are possible. That the thing which I saw before as impossible, I begin to see them as possible. Oh, praise his holy name. But as I renew my mind, I begin to see that death is not my portion. As I renew my mind, I begin to see that no situation is above the word of God. As I renew my mind, I begin to see that Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. As I begin to renew my mind, I begin to see that I am blessed beyond any curse. As I all that takes to renew your mind on daily basis, that you may be able to prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God. Maybe I have to go to that one right now. Let's talk about the will of God a little bit. Jesus taught his disciples and said, as you pray, say, let your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. So it is possible for the will of God in heaven to be done on earth. It takes us to pray. Every time you pray, Father, let your will be done. Let your will be done. But you know, do you know what most Christians pray? They say, Father, if it be your will, if it be your will. What do you mean by that? Father, if it is your will. So you don't know whether it is his will or not. Jesus told his disciples, when you pray, say, let your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Let your will. That means he expected them to know the will of God concerning their lives, so that they may go to him in prayer and say, Father, you said this. Now I come to you that your will, which you said here, be done here on earth right now. You said that by your stripes I'm healed. You said so that by your stripes I'm healed. Yes. So I've come to pray. Let your will be done here on earth as it is in heaven. I take my healing right now. That's the way it's supposed to be. But you know what? Most people say, Lord, if it is your will, Lord, if it... And after they leave prayer, they say, I wonder whether it's his will. I don't know whether you'll do it. Is that faith? That's not faith. That is doubt. Oh, bless the name of Jesus. Oh, Pastor, don't forget that Jesus also said, and said, if it be your will, the situations are different. Jesus' situation and yours, they are different. The situations are different. Now, go with me to Mark chapter 3 and verse 32. Mark chapter 3 and verse 32. Praise the Lord. Mark chapter 3 and verse 32. He said, Jesus said, Mark 3:32, and the multitude sat about him, and they said unto him, behold, thy mother and thy brethren without seek for thee. Yeah, your mother and your brethren are looking for you. And he answered them, saying, who is my mother? Oh, my brethren. And he looked around about on them which sat about him and said, behold, my mother and my brethren. For whosoever shall do the will of God, the same is my brother and my sister and my mother. Have you heard that? Whoever shall do the will. Oh, no, I don't care as long as I'm anointed. No. There are so many anointed people out there who have no clue of God's will. They have no idea whatsoever of God's will. And they are a wreck of themselves. And yet they're anointed. Some have big titles. They are prophets, they are apostles, they are evangelists, and they have no clue of God's will. What has he said? Whosoever shall do the will of God. That's why I need to renew my mind every day, that I may be transformed to be able to prove the good, the acceptable, and perfect will of God. Because situations change here on earth every time. So I need to know the will of God concerning every situation. And that takes renewing your mind so you may be transformed. You don't study the word of God in vain. Every time you study the word of God, you are renewing your mind. That's marvelous light coming your way. Oh, bless his holy name. Oh, bless the name of Jesus. Let me finish with Matthew chapter 7. Matthew chapter 7. I'm sure you are set. So you're going to allow the light of the Lord to shine in your life and renew your mind. And you know, he said in 2 Corinthians chapter 3 that with an open face we behold the glory, and we are transformed into the same image. You need to be transformed. What worked yesterday may not necessarily work today. It is the same scripture, but you need to renew your mind with it so you may be able to prove God's perfect will. The scripture has not changed. God's will has not changed, but your mind needs to be renewed. Your mind needs to be renewed. The information you had yesterday needs upgrading today. It needs to be updating. You need to download more information concerning your situation today. Oh, bless the name of Jesus. All right, Matthew 7:21, Jesus said, these are the words of Jesus. He said, not everyone that says unto me, Lord, Lord, shall enter into the kingdom of heaven, but he that doeth the will of my Father which is in heaven. You see how so important it is to renew your mind? Let the marvelous light shine over you. Renew your mind and be transformed so you may be able to tell God's perfect will. That is awesome. I wish I could overemphasize it. That situation change every day. You wake up one morning and the Lord tells you, take this direction. You wake up another day and tells you, take this direction. You reach your office and he tells you, go and speak so and so. You reach your fish and tells you, don't say anything to anyone. The things are, you know, we need to know his perfect will. Or will I say hourly basis? Will I say minute by minute? Should I say all the time? All the time. And what does this take? It takes you to renew your mind. The information you had yesterday is not enough. You need to upgrade it. To update, because some of you say, but yesterday I read 5 chapters. Should I read today again? Today should even read 10. You should even read 10. Yesterday you read 2 chapters. Today you ought to have read 3, because you renew your mind. And as you renew your mind, you get transformed from a caterpillar to a butterfly. From a caterpillar to a butterfly. Let me show. So he said, not everyone that says unto me, Lord, Lord, shall enter in the kingdom of heaven, but he that doeth the will of my Father, which is in heaven. Verse 22, he said, many will say to me in that day, Lord, 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 have we not prophesied in your name? And in thy name have cast out devils? And in thy name done many wonderful works? And then will I profess unto them, I never knew you. Doing God's will. What? I never knew. Depart from me, ye that work iniquity. When we heal the sick, when you prophesied, like people are so intrigued with prophecy. Hey, he's prophesying, she's prophesying. She, you know, she can prophesy into your life. She can prophesy into your life. Oh my goodness. I'm not against prophecy. Blessings. So, from this day, begin to know that this year, his marvelous light is coming your way, that you may renew your mind, that you may get transformed. Bless the Lord. That you may know God's perfect will concern you. You will be amazed the way God works. You know, I've been born again for some time, but a time came when I surrendered. And I began to say, except the Lord shows me the way, I'm not going anywhere. Because I was used to my own way. Yesterday he did like this. Even today he'll do it like that. Then he doesn't do it. So now I just flow with him. What I do is to renew my mind. I renew my mind with new information. I get his word. I may read the same scripture, but this is the word of God. It keeps on renewing my mind. And as it renews my mind, I get transformed. I gave you the definition of transformation. That a process of profound and radical change that takes you into a new direction, takes you to another level altogether of effectiveness. So the Lord wants you to be transformed every day. You cannot go with the information you had yesterday. You need information for today. You need to get the new password for the day. Bless the name of Jesus. That's why we have his marvelous light to transform our lives. That's why we have his word to transform our lives. Oh, bless the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Just in case you are in this service and you're not born again, you can get born again right now. You can say this with me. Father, in the name of Jesus, I believe with my heart that you raised Christ from the dead. I believe with my heart to receive righteousness. And with my mouth, I confess that Jesus is Lord. And with my mouth, I confess that I am born again. Oh, if you say those words, if you say those words from your heart, you are born again. You can tell every brother, you can tell someone that I'm born again. I got born again from that service. Oh, praise the Lord. And the rest of us, please just speak to the Lord and tell him, Lord, 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 I need the transformation of my mind. Yes, I need serious transformation of my life. Lord, help me to renew my mind. Open my eyes to these secrets. That I may know how to renew my mind. That I may be transformed. That I may be able to tell your perfect will per time. Oh, Jesus. Thank you, Father, for this day. Thank you for opening our eyes to know how so important your will is. Oh, Lord Jesus, and we are ready to do your will. Let your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Let your will be done on earth and help us to know your will, to know your good and bad, so we may not conform to this world. We refuse to conform to this world. We refuse to go the way the worldly go. We refuse to get things the way the worldly get them. But we open our hearts to you, Lord, to be transformed, that we may know your good, acceptable, and perfect will for our lives. We thank you so much, Lord. We bless your name, O Lord. We worship your name, O Lord. Every day, Lord Jesus, help us to renew our minds that we may be transformed. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord, in the name of Jesus. The Lord bless you, my brother, my sister, ever you are. Some of you are my fathers, some of you are my mothers. But the Lord bless you. And I thank God for your lives. I know something good has happened to you when you heard that word. And I know you're going to take it serious. And the Lord bless you and magnify his name over you. And may the Lord make his power and anointing to flow into your life as never before as you renew your mind. Oh, praise the name of Jesus. And right now, I want to remind you that our week of praises is coming on. And also that we migrated from 5 p.m. to 7 p.m. And also that, but that this Sunday, the services are the same. The Lord bless you. Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives. And we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever with his marvelous light. Forever with his marvelous light. Forever with his marvelous light. Amen and amen. The Lord bless you and keep you.